One of the things that can happen when we don't get enough sleep is it changes our thinking abilities, ability to be able to process information effectively. It can also impair your memory, and there's a couple of reasons for both of these effects. As far as the thinking problems and the memory, in fact, insomnia increases cortisol levels. Cortisol is the stress hormone, we think of it. It also contributes to the fight or flight response, giving that surge of adrenaline. And so it is very useful. We do need cortisol, but what we don't need is elevated levels of cortisol just kind of sitting there, sitting around. Elevated levels of cortisol can cause memory problems or trouble retrieving information. And this is the same kind of decline in memory that we see with age-related changes. That's one of the causes of age-related or senile dementia, we sometimes refer to it as. So as far as memories go, it's the slow wave sleep that helps consolidate declarative memories. And it's REM sleep that helps consolidate procedural memories. Now, what are these two different types of memories? Just for your information. Declarative memories is the ability to remember facts and things that we've learned in the past, such as, say, a to-do list. I can, at the beginning of my day, have this to-do list of things that I want to do today. And then as the day progresses, I file back and recall things. Oh yeah, grocery store, pick up dry cleaning, these sorts of things. That would be declarative memory. Procedural memory would be memory for things like tasks that you've learned, procedures you can think of it as, like riding a bike, or even something like learning Photoshop, which is a pretty complex program. But learning things that you have learned and where there's several steps, and after a while those things can become very rote, and it's not an effort to remember how to ride a bicycle, for example. So the reason this is important is because when you get less sleep, let's say you only sleep 4 hours, who knows how that translates into how much less slow wave sleep you've gotten and how much less REM you've gotten. You've had less time in the laboratory forming these memories. And this can have really important implications for people, students who are studying, staying up late, let's pull an all-nighter to remember these facts and things. And perhaps you may be able to stuff some of it down, but you're really compromising your ability to really learn and remember when intuitively it seems that if you just spend more time, you'll be able to remember, and it actually works against you. So another quick analogy to illustrate the difference between procedural memory and declarative memory for those of you who like technology would be to compare it to the memory in your computer. The computer has two types of memory, the RAM, which is random access memory, and ROM, which is typically what we think of as the computer's hard drive where things are permanently stored. So for us, our declarative memory would be RAM. That's our ability to quickly remember things, keep a lot of things in our head. If you have a computer that has lots of RAM, gigabytes, several gigabytes of RAM, you're going to be able to run a lot of programs at the same time, click here, click there, have the internet, your email, something else going, and hardly be slowed down at all. If you don't have enough RAM, you're going to click and have to wait, see the hourglass, and things might even freeze on you. So where do we get this RAM? Well, first of all, taking it to the workplace, if you have the kind of job where you really have to be on your toes for most of the day, you've got people asking you questions, you've got to recall things that came up in meetings yesterday and be able to act on that information, etc., you need a lot of RAM. So where do you get the RAM? The RAM comes in the slow wave sleep portion. So it's that deep sleep, the restorative sleep, as far as there's lots of things that happen during that phase, but also consolidating our declarative memory. Then our REM sleep would be responsible for consolidating the ROM, or our ROM, our hard drive that keeps up with the procedures that become rote for us, like the riding of the bicycle, washing dishes, driving a car, things that we hardly give any thought to because we filed it away as a memory that's in our hard drive that we can easily draw from. So now that you have an earful about different types of memory, suffice it to say that it's the forming of these memories and enabling us to be able to think and process and be sharp and on our toes is very dependent on how much sleep we get. So next lecture is health problems that turn up when you don't get enough sleep.